Hey everyone, welcome back to Alf's Mustang Garage. Today we're back on the 67 Mustang. We're doing a turn signal switch. So, if you're following the channel, the previous video, we showed you how to diagnose that. The concern was the left brake light wasn't working. We went through what I do to diagnose those kinds of concerns. And we came to the conclusion that the stoplight switch was feeding the turn signal switch, but the turn signal switch was not feeding the brake light circuit. And that's how these operate. So we're gonna have to tear into that, take the steering wheel off, and get into the turn signal switch. So if you didn't get a chance to see the diagnostic video, I'll put a card that will slide across right here so you can catch that to see all my diagnostic electrical tips on how to properly diagnose this. I know sometimes electrical is one of those things that we just dread, and you know, especially with brake lights, like brake lights don't work, okay, new bulb. Doesn't fix it, okay, now what? So anyways, I show you how to test the stoplight switch and then ultimately test the turn signal switch and kind of, you know, look at the diagrams and things like that. But anyways, so let's jump right into taking this steering wheel off and we'll see if we can see if my diagnostic was correct. Okay, so to get started on this, first thing you gotta do is take your steering wheel off. Now I know in today's day and age, you're gonna come across lots of cars that have aftermarket wheels like this, but the process is still gonna be relatively similar. Looks like with this Grant GT, we gotta undo these five Allen head screws, maybe we can get this wheel off. Also, before I get into the horn contacts, and those kinds of things, I disconnect my battery. That's always a good practice for when you're tearing into anything kind of electrical. So disconnect your battery first, steering wheel removal second. Okay, once you have those five set screws removed, you're gonna reveal the horn contacts. So we're just gonna pull those off really easy like that. And of course your battery is disconnected, so now your steering wheel you can set aside. Okay, so now you're gonna reveal you got three bolts here and a center nut, and that's your center steering shaft. So we're going to remove these three bolts and then remove this nut. It's usually on there pretty good. Impact works great. So, and then we'll probably get a steering wheel puller on this to get this off. Okay, so we're gonna get this large center nut off here. But before we do, we're going to just kind of make sure we orient ourselves correctly. We want our wheels to be pointed, steering straight. We want to kind of mark the top of this. That way your steering wheel goes back on straight. Just kind of make some indicators. Looks like someone's been in here before. I put a U right here, but I'm also just gonna kind of orient where the shaft is in relation to here. That way everything's just kind of pointing straight up. So that way I get everything back to where it was. Okay, so impact gun makes really quick, easy work of that. And now this unit can come off. So we've oriented where that's gonna be pointed up. That way it goes right back in the same spot. And now we have a plate right there. Now we have, looks like our horn contact. And this is where we probably need a steering wheel puller to actually get this off. We have to pull this off of your shaft. Okay, so your standard steering wheel puller. You want this end to be contacting here in the middle on the shaft. Put your bolts through. Typically you want to grab a fairly good amount of threads on there so you don't just rip the threads out. So now it looks like it's just barely gonna be hitting the end there. So you wanna be really careful with this. You don't want to like slip off and damage the threads on your steering shaft. So we really want to make sure that that's on there really good. Okay, so the trick that I have found when doing these kind of styles, you only got you know, a 2-bolt steering wheel puller, you don't want to damage your threads. Put your nut, your steering shaft nut, back on, but not all the way on. Okay, just kind of put it on just like that. That way there's a gap and that can pop up. And now you have some extra space to get onto, and you're not going to damage your threads in the process. So there's how I'm set up. It's just kind of on the edge there. We're going to hand tighten this. I'm not going to use an impact. I'm just going to go nice and slow, hand tighten it, and get this thing to pop up. And there it is. It just pops right up. Okay, just like with everything else that we've taken off, we just kind of want to line everything up. This actually has the words top right here. So I think I can probably use that reference point where I'm marked right here with my top. So I'm good to line everything right back up like that. It's kind of got some spring tension on it. And it's off. Just like that. Now we have our access to our turn signal switch. Okay, so we have a spring that we're going to take off right there. Your turn signal lever, this just threads off. Just like that. And it looks like there are 3 set screws for that switch. Phillips head set screws, and then we can start to kind of pull this out. As we pull it out, we're gonna remove this little bezel here for our hazard, which looks like that's broken off anyway, so that's kind of an added bonus in replacing this. We're gonna actually have a hazard switch now. Okay, so we got those 3 set screws removed, so we should be able to kind of work this up. I can work the little bezel off like that for the hazard switch. Now these wires, they actually go through the tube here for your column. So you're gonna have to kind of massage these down here, kind of help feed it up through the tube in order to actually get it out. Just gonna kind of use my pick and get up underneath here like this and kind of help pull this out. Okay, so what I'm having to do is just kind of force these up because they don't slide up very easily just by pulling at the top. So as I kind of force those up, I'm able to slide that off the shaft now, just like that. Okay, so as we pull this out, you can kind of get a really good look at what's going on back here and do some additional testing, which I think I do, but I'm going to be changing this out anyways because, you know, broken hazard switch. I see some chafing going on right here with some exposed wire. If you're not planning on keeping this, you can just cut your wires down here and now pull your entire assembly out of the column, and then the new ones will just get fed down the column tube. We're just gonna go ahead and cut these wires, and then we'll be able to pull it out of the column tube. Just as a reminder, make sure your battery is disconnected first before you do this. Okay, there's your turn signal switch removal process. When you get your new switch, you can actually get new connectors like this. That way you don't have to like pull out all the old wires. I was dumb enough and forgot to order a connector, so I'm going to have to reuse the one I have. So we just got to pull out all these pins. So just to kind of show you what I'm doing, they have little tabs that kind of protrude from the side, and that's what kind of, it's like a Chinese finger trap, and that way if it tries to come out, it just won't come out. So what I'm doing is I'm using my pick and I'm pushing these tabs down, okay, and then you can pull it out. So, and then at the same time, you want to like make sure, you know, the same color wires go back in the same location. So you can do this kind of one at a time, or you can just, you know, pull them all out, and then, you know, obviously you have the other side underneath the car right up in here, and you can just kind of match up and make sure all your colors go in the correct slots, because it's just like anything else, they have to go in the correct slots. So anyway, so we're going to pull all these out and fish the new ones in, but we're not going to do that until we actually slide all the wires down the tube. Okay, so I tried doing the whole coat hanger trick, but it was just too hard to get all the wires in there at the same time. There's just too small of a spot, because it kind of goes in and then it kind of curves and then goes down the column. So, but if you just kind of insert them like one at a time, get them all started, and they just kind of go right down. So that was by far way easier than trying to run a coat hanger and all that kind of stuff. So. Okay, so I was just kind of fighting getting the little post in here for the turn signal lever, and then getting your bezel on there. So just kind of trying to fight all that kind of stuff, and then kind of tug a little bit on our wires. Okay, you just want to kind of make sure that you're not pinching any wires underneath everything here while you're getting your set in place. Okay, so now that you've got your switch assembly all screwed down, you can insert your turn signal lever, and you can just kind of test and make sure your cam's working correctly. So you can go right and left, and when turning right, you're turning right, and then you turn backwards to straighten the car out. It cancels. Same thing with left. You're turning left. You turn back. It cancels. Put your hazard switch in, and the cancel cam will actually pop that back out as well. So essentially what we're going to do is we're going to match up our colors to here, and make sure that this is all correct. So this connector only goes in one way. Now these little wires, they're just gonna kind of plug right in and click. So we're looking for orange wire. Now there's no two wires that are the same color. So we got orange with blue. And there's an orange with blue right here. This is why I should have got a new one of these connectors. They're only like $5. And I just kind of forgot to order it, but we're here now. That one's kind of being a bugger. Got my little needle nose here, and I can kind of just pull it through. Okay. And next is white with blue. White. Yep, white with blue. And then just so you know, like, depending on what car you're working on or what application you're working on, your replacement may not necessarily be the same colors. I've seen that before. So just kind of like, you know, double check and make sure that everything is actually the same color on your replacement. Okay, so we got everything connected here. We're gonna test everything to make sure we're all good and correct. Just so you know, like, depending on what you're working on, what year and whatnot, sometimes these wires will change color when it passes through a connection like this. So, you know, don't always rely on color. You know, maybe take a picture of this before you take it all apart. Make sure your wiring schematic is correct, and then you can like piece it all together. But don't solely rely on color alone, because you know, that, you know, only gets you so far sometimes. Okay, so now that I'm all connected down here, I'm secure up here, I'm safe to put my battery back on. Now I can test some stuff. So the first thing you can test is, you know, your horn. Here's your horn contacts. Looks like I got power there. I should have power on one. The other path is the ground path. So if I were to cross these two, my horn should activate. Which it does. Turn the key on. Should have my turn signals, which I do. There's left. There's right. I should have brake lights too. Make sure my lights are working. Yep. Yep. Let's see if I fix the primary concern, brake lights. Yep. Both my brake lights are working. Fantastic. So I know I fixed the primary concern and everything else is working. You can test all this stuff, you know, before you put everything back together. Okay, before you begin this installation process, pretty straightforward. You took it all apart, so reverse of, you know, putting it all back together. Sometimes it can be a little tricky with this aftermarket stuff. So one thing to kind of not forget is this little pin right here. That's a little alignment pin to make sure it turns. Okay, it has to go into this slot here. And granted, this is an aftermarket unit, but you know, that pin is there for a reason, for whatever, you know, unit you're using. And then as you turn the steering wheel, it's going to turn your cam and thus cancel your turn signal. Don't forget that. Put it all back together, and then you won't be upset when your turn signals don't cancel and you gotta take it all apart. Okay, we're all back together here. Horn is working. Of course, it's aftermarket. We just have to, you know, kind of clean up our wires here, wrap them up and tuck them back in so they're nice and clean. Our turn signals are working. And let's see if they cancel. Yes, they do. Go to the left. Everything's canceling. And most importantly, We already verified this, but brake lights are working, if you can see the reflection off the door. So yeah, that's how you do a turn signal switch. I also like to be very thorough in my diagnostics, that way I know for sure that's what it is. So anyways, thanks for watching. Appreciate your time. Don't forget to like the video if you got value out of it. Comment if you have any questions. And in the meantime, we'll catch you next time.